Sometimes a Viking is born with the spark of gods within them, destined to lead their people into battle, to glory, and of course...
Valhalla!
Valhalla!
Welcome, everyone. I am your host, the Khan Beastador, and today we will be taking an in-depth look at the fearless Dane axe-wielding raider. It is said that just hearing of a raider's existence is enough to summon armies, and that they have the spark of gods within them, a warrior of unequaled strength and fury wielding the mightiest weapon of the Viking people. They know that Valhalla waits for them, but they shall leave a bloody trail a lifetime long behind them, and I will show you how. Before we get into this, I really just want to take a moment to say thank you to everyone watching this video, all of my subscribers, all of you guys that's leaving the thumbs up on the videos. I cannot tell you how much it means to me because this is the first tutorial I'm putting out at over 100 subscribers. I can't believe the rate at which this channel has grown, and it's all thanks to you. So thank you, truly, thank you so much for your support. And let's go ahead and learn a little bit more about the Raider. Who better to help us than Raiderbot, our twin doppelganger? So the thing that needs to be noted about the Raider's playstyle is he does a lot of damage. When people ask you, hey, how do you play the Raider? You say, he does a lot of damage. His moveset's very simple. Hit the ideas behind playing him, very, very simple. But just use the ideas to apply massive damage. So Renown and Revenge mode, all the characters have that. Let's get into the special stuff. Stampede Charge. If you've played against Raiders, this has been done to you. They will run at you and press X. It's this attack right here, Stampede Charge. All you do is run at the opponent and hold X. And the more you hold X, the longer you will carry them. So just go ahead, give them a big old hug, and just Well, that's another special feature. Let's go ahead and talk about that while that just happened out of the blue. So basically, if you use that attack to run them into a wall or other physical object, you will actually knee them in the face and stun them, which means that they can't see where your reticle is. I'll go ahead and try and recreate that in a bit, but let's get the main one down. So give them a hug, and you can just carry them. The longer you hold X, the further you carry them. And it does a fair amount of stamina damage too, but you can just do a little tap, you know, throw them a couple feet, but the longer you hold X, the more distance you get with them. Oop. Next up, controlled throw. This one took me a little while, and I'm fairly certain I understand how this works, and will tell you as well. Basically, this appears to only work on the backwards throw of the guard break. And it says hold or release X to manage where you throw the enemy. Your opponent loses stamina each time he knocks into a nearby character. So, simply grab your opponent, a guard break, and throw him backwards. So if you just do it tap like normal, he'll just be thrown backwards like that. Nothing unusual about that. However, if you hold it down, you can do as much as spin him 360 degrees and throw him back to the front of you. Basically, the idea is if you let go any time during that sequence, you can throw him different places. So if you go like this, you can throw him like 270 degrees, which would usually be a left-hand throw. But you can do it anywhere. It doesn't have to be the cardinal directions. You can do a weird one, like a little bit more than 180. You know, you don't have to do any of the cardinal directions. It really enables you to do a 360 throw. And it has the benefit of every single time he hits an opponent, he actually loses stamina. So in area B for Dominion, just throw him into all of those minions and his stamina will just get eaten. That's more or less how you use it. Raider's Fury. This attack is unblockable and can be used in any chain. So, basically, in my opinion, the Raider has the best area clear of the game. Of any character, his area clear attack is the best. Not only does it use less stamina than any other character's area clear, but it's unblockable and can be used in any combo. So Raider's Fury can actually be used with the chop and poke, wild swinging, winding slashes, anywhere in any combo, you can just pop that Raider's Fury and it's unblockable. It has a massive, massive arc, really hard to get around it. So I will go ahead and show you, not in a combo per se, but just, there you go, his area clear. Now, as you can see, it doesn't do a lot of damage, and as I said at the beginning of this, you said, Conquistador, you said that it does, you know, how you play the Raider, he does a lot of damage. And it's true, he does. There is a way to make this attack do massive, unforgivable amounts of damage. So I will definitely get into that very shortly. Next up on our list, we have Stunning Tap Variation. All this is a heavy cancel. So out of any heavy attack, you can actually cancel into a light attack. And you will stop your momentum and instead hit them in the face with the end of your axe and stun them. So let's go ahead and just get right about here. So a normal heavy attack, like that. At the beginning of the animation, however, you can actually cancel out of it and do the tap instead. So normal attack, cancel out of it. Cancel out of it. So it has to be fairly near the beginning of the animation for it to work. And it also needs to be noted that that tap actually comes from the above every single time. So if you do end up spamming it, your opponent will punish you for it. They'll know it's coming. And that's all of his special stuff. He's a very, you know, simple character to learn. His ideas are very simple, but they're used to apply massive damage. And I will get into that. So chop and poke. Very, very simple. Wild swinging, very, very simple. Whining slashes. I would recommend maybe not using this unless you're being very unpredictable with your stances, because that light attack in the middle tends to get deflected and then ends your turn. If they block that middle attack, your chain is done. So I kind of either go with chop and poke or wild swinging, just in general. Chop and poke, super easy, just one, two, three. Three light attacks. Let's see if we can get two off on Raider, but he's very good at blocking. Yep. One, two, and then theoretically three. It's more used for fast opponents like Orochi who have to actively block. You know, assassin classes like Peacekeeper, Orochi, Berserker. And then, of course, Wild Swinging. In my opinion, the bread and butter of the Raider. It does lots of damage. And that is the key phrase to using Raider effectively. It does lots of damage. Look at that. Just one little attack. Also something that needs to be noted, each attack that is successive in the chain actually does more damage than the last. So your first attack's gonna do good damage. The second attack, wow, that's a lot of damage. And the third attack is, ooh man, that was brutal. So as you can see, two attacks landed, only two. His health is down to half. If that last attack had landed, he would have been in trouble. Like one more, you know, you could have sneezed in his general direction. That was a total of five attacks right there. Boom. Now we get into the Raider's Fury, the area clear. I said that this can really end up doing some more damage than it looked like it did. At the beginning, if you're just sitting there and you just use it, less than impressive. You know, it's a bar and a half. It's a good amount of damage. However, the further in a chain that it lands, the more damage it does. So let's say one, two. Oh, so close. All right, let's go. One, two, boom. Look at that. Two and maybe a quarter full bars. More than twice as much damage because it's at the end of the chain. So if you can help it, go ahead and get these heavy attacks off and then boom, look at that. Massive, massive damage. And you can just do one and then heavy and it'll still do a lot of damage. Not to mention its tracking is fantastic. Its arc is huge. There's no way for people to get around it. The only ones that are going to give you trouble are those dodgy ones, such as Peacekeepers, Orochis, Berserkers, who aren't terrified of the massive Raider in front of them. If they can keep a level head, you can actually dodge through it. But most people, when you have a massive Danax-wielding Viking, they tend to get a little scared, lose their head. So, Reaping Charge, super easy. That's his other running attack. So, it's a decent running attack, too. Boom, that's it. And it's just, you run at him and heavy attack. It does decent damage, doesn't take a whole lot of stamina. It's not particularly fast, and it will go over the heads of the first couple enemies on Dominion. So if you're doing it to Dominion Clear, you might miss a couple just because the initial setup of it starts high and comes lower. But other than that, it's a good move. I really wouldn't... I'd either start any given engagement you're running into with either the charge or that attack. There's not really a reason not to. Alrighty, and then Stunning Tap. Believe it or not, the Raider, he's got quick feet. He's a quick guy. He actually has stun attacks. He has dodge attacks, I'm sorry. Like the Kensai, like the Orochi. He actually can dodge and attack at the same time. So he simply dodges and attacks. Now, this is something I need to note about the Raider. Now, the Orochi, the Kensai, these characters actually get invincibility frames during their dodges. To my knowledge, in my experience, the Raider does not. His dodge appears to be almost entirely movement-based. So, just getting out of the way is the only thing that this dodge does. You can dodge up under axes and things like that, but you don't actually have the ability to have a weapon pass through you like you can with the Orochi and the Kensai and others. But the idea is, yeah, this little attack, it's the same exact attack as the heavy cancel. So what you do is you simply run at the opponent, dodge in any direction, press the light attack button, and you'll pop him in the head real quick. And that'll stun them. They can't see where your next attack is coming from. And although technically not a chain by itself, it actually offers a very strong damage possibility. Because what the moveset doesn't teach you is that it can actually be followed up immediately by a heavy attack. So you can pop them in the head and then heavy attack. Yeah, it's fantastic at getting really fast enemies to, you know, punish them. Dodging, stuff like that. You can actually use your little maneuver, really, and try and get in there first. And then, there we go. Also, that does count as a strong attack and can lead to executions, which is fantastic. Now, he is also, like I said, he's a quick on his feet guy. He can actually guard break out of any direction. Like I was saying in my Kensei and Valkyrie videos, the dodge grabs really, really overpowered, but they can do that only in one direction, and that's forward. The Viking, the Raider here, can do it in all three directions. Let's see if Raider Battle let us happen. See, there we go. Dodge that way. Nope. Hold on. We can do it. Left, right. And actually, this is a fantastic time to talk about this. When you're doing it to the sides like that, you have almost no tracking at all. You have to be up in their face. You have to be really, really close. In my Orochi video, you saw you can really give some tracking to your guard breaks, but with the Raider, you actually have to be really up in their face for it to work. Boom. So you can do it forward. You can throw them in any direction after you do any dodge. So you can go dodge right, throw right, dodge left, throw left. It doesn't matter. But most importantly, you can actually do the running attack. Running guard break. Just like you can do the charge. So just grab them, and the forward one acts the same as the running charge. And you can use this to throw people into walls just the same way that you can with the initial running X attack. And that's actually all you need to know. That's all the things that you need to know about Raider to make him effective in combat. So let's go ahead and put Raiderbot to rest here. He's been fantastic, but you know what? I think it's time for us to go ahead and get into some PvP and show you what the Raider can really do, yeah? Woot! Alrighty, and here we go. We're gonna go ahead and see what kind of trouble we can get up to with the Raider and Dominion. Now, I don't have enough time to go ahead and go through all of these individually to show you what they are, so I'm gonna quickly just cycle through them and let you see what he has at least, and you can read what it does. I will be making a feat-based video at some point in the future, and it'll include how to use all the feats and what they are, but for now, this is just what the Raider has access to. So, I really can't stress this enough. The Raider is all about attack. The second you start being defensive with him, much like the Valkyrie actually, you're gonna go ahead and bite it. Especially against faster enemies. Now, you really need to keep the small zippy ones from pressing their speed advantage, because the Raider has no means of defense. That's the problem. His stance change seems to be quite slow. He has no punish for parries and things like that, so parries are pretty meaningless to him, other than avoiding maybe unblockables. And overall, his attack speed is not very high, which means that from the get-go, you need to be pressing your offensive, because that axe, it does a lot of damage. Not only that, I do need to make a note that the Raider, amongst all others I've seen, benefits from equipment. So we're gonna go ahead and dive right into here. I won't skimp over that. Equipment makes such a massive difference on a Raider. The difference in attack power that you can gain from equipment on a Raider is enormous. Let's go ahead and help our buddy out here. Just shove her right against the wall, get that stun right off the bat. Unfortunately, our buddy did not make it, but let's go ahead and avenge him. Sounds good to me. So, Nabushi are gonna give you some real trouble, because they can change their stance so fast, and they have that hidden stance. It's gonna give you some problems, so really my advice on that is, if you can get some distance, use that unblockable, otherwise go for this thump right on the head, just like that. It's fast, it does a nice bit of damage to these lighter classes, and it stuns. So their whole being able to change stances thing, it's a lot harder for them. So let's go ahead and move on. And that's the thing, you've got to be constantly aggressing. Ignore the guy doing the mannequin challenge. Obviously, that guy right there, let him do his thing. But you know what? You got to be aggressive. You got to find your next target. You're all about getting into Valhalla. So let's take this Conqueror out right now. Okay, well, that just happened. That's fine. Okay, well, you know what? A Raider is a more worthy target anyways, I think. Valhalla will go ahead. Okay, well, we have ghosts. Ghost Illuminati. Actually, Illuminati confirmed. Yep. You heard it here first. Ghost Illuminati. Whatever. Alrighty, so something to note about the Raider is he's fantastic at clearing B. Oh my gosh, he is so good. Between his abilities, that massive swing of the axe, and most importantly, his ability to kill minions with his chain. His minion chain. I'll explain a little bit after this quick clip here. Oh, hey, look. Oh, a little too early there, buddy. You know what? I'm just gonna give you a hug. Your friend's dead. You're the dead. Did I ever mention in any of my past videos that Vikings really like throwing? They love to throw. Man, Vikings love to throw. So what I meant by the minion chain is I've noticed that characters actually have what I like to call minion chains, where they kill minions in rapid succession using different moves. And it's always important to do so, because B will go back to neutral if left to its own devices. Let's go ahead and talk about this Kensei real quick, before we get into that. He's too fast. We're not going to be able to get our heavies off. They're too easy to parry. So really go for that combo right there, where you dodge the attack, pop him in the head, and then get that immediate heavy afterwards. I didn't land it there, and that probably would have made the difference in that fight, but you get the idea. Pop them in the head and go ahead and sweep them with that heavy attack from either side when they're stunned. What I meant by minion chains, though, is that I've noticed that, let's say, the Lawbringer. If you do light attack, heavy attack, light attack, heavy attack, light attack, heavy attack, he'll actually do a combo where he starts like chain killing these minions instead of just doing the pitchfork over and over again. It's much faster. Well, with the Raider, it's just light attack, light attack, light attack. Let's go ahead and help out the Valkyrie here. It's a great help to teammates to shove them right against the wall like that. I may have been able to save this Valkyrie if the Conqueror perhaps did not stop me from doing my heavy attacks there. If they've got low health like that, don't even risk them blocking the attacks. That has great tracking, that area clear, it's unblockable, fantastic tracking, huge arc, and a big heavy guy like Shigoki, he's not gonna get out of the way, there's no way. And this is what I'm talking about right here, between his abilities, his easy minion combo, boom, look at that. Let's just check that counter, yep, 32 minions right off the bat, easy. He's fantastic at clearing me. But these zippy guys here, you have to press your aggressive on them, because their speed will destroy you. Make them scared of that massive damage. Make them go on the offensive by constantly pressing your attack, and then it's gonna be an easy kill. That being said, you will have the most trouble with these quick zippy little guys, because if they keep a level head, there's not a whole lot you can do about them. Here's an important tip as well. If you see someone with that little health, go ahead and throw them to the ground, because you have one light attack of guaranteed damage. If you try to go for the heavy, they have time to stand up and potentially block. The light attack, not so much. Go for that guaranteed light attack if you know it's going to finish them off. Or not, just start your combo with that. So here we go, we have a little enemy here. Nice little Orochi. This right there, boom, that's actually the light attack. Against the Orochi and things like that, it's actually a lot more preferable than your heavy, because they have to actively block. So as long as you're unpredictable with where your attack is coming from, you'll deal probably the whole chain. It'd be very difficult for them to block it. Now I need to emphasize again, B will go neutral if you don't just do this little clearing here. You just gotta clear them up a little bit, just every now and then, and just 10 guys, you know? Keep it in your zone. Keep it under your control. So we're gonna go here back to A. I think Shigoki is stirring up trouble here. He seems to like this place. I miss my grab because he's got his uninterruptible stance. I don't do a great job of saving my teammate, but you know what? I think that's okay. Look at that damage. That is 3/4 of a Shigoki's health right off the bat. Let's see if we can't finish this guy. Of course, good guy teammate coming in. Nice job, teammate. Thank you for that, Conqueror. We make a pretty good team, you and me, Conqueror. Alrighty. And again, just always be going, oh man, if the enemies aren't here, you go to where the enemies are. He doesn't hold places. Shigoki, great at holding places. Lawbringer, fantastic at, you know, environmental kills, holding places. Not so much the Raider. You attack an enemy on your terms. You attack and you push the advantage on your terms. That's where he shines. So right now, things aren't going so good. Oh man, well, that Kensai popped his thing where all of his attacks become invulnerable. I mean, uninterruptible. No, I'm sorry, unblockable. Oh, maybe English rival. Maybe I'll English someday. Go ahead and try and get all that damage in there, but 3-on-1, the Kensai unblockable, all that good stuff. Well, it looks like it's the end here. So I'm going to go ahead and take some time to talk about some specifics with the Raider. I didn't really get to touch a lot because it was a Kaikai. What is this? A miracle? We got a double ladder kill. Well, well, ladies and gentlemen, it might not be the end after all. And we managed to push them into the brink. So now all we need is our Conqueror to defeat this Shigoki. And I think we're going to be fine. Man, this got exciting all of a sudden. It's not just a tutorial anymore. This is a real game. We got a shot here. Oh, man. That's no fun. No fun at all. Well, you know what? We got one lone bot ready to go. And he manages to neutralize B. That's right. I cannot believe I said this. A bot managed to pull that one right from the abyss. So we all get a second chance here. Now we got a game. Now we got a fight. the thing about the Raider is he can really do all of this damage. Like, once I get in here and once I start just messing people up, you're gonna see how much damage and how much of a difference that an aggressive Raider can make. So go ahead and try and get an advantage there. Oh, if I didn't get hit by my own team's catapult, I probably would have gotten in there. Never follow an enemy up the ladder, though. If you see them go somewhere, don't follow them. They can ladder cheese you. And that right there is a perfect example of if that enemy looks like he's gonna get away, try and use that double A to get back. You just pop him right with that unblockable. Again, huge range, great tracking, very hard to get away from it. So, and it's fantastic for ending and executing opponents. All right, let's just go ahead and get right in this. Our Conqueror just took an arrow to the face. That's not very good. But as you can see, I managed to melt that Kensai in practically one combo. You can do amazing damage if your opponent is distracted. See, let's look at the Shigoki. Boom. He's down to one bar left. And of course, Shigokis are going to go for the tackle. So go ahead and just one quick backstep is usually enough. Bop him real quick in the head and just... And all we have left is this Nabushi. So just remember, Nabushi, fast. If it's a fast opponent, use the head bob attack. If it's a slow opponent, unblockables. And that's all you need to know. I cannot believe that round turned out the way that it did, but man, it turned out absolutely fantastic. Great teamwork on everyone's part. We actually ended up doing it with two bots, which is crazy. But there you go, 5 objectives, 12 takedowns, and only 2 deaths. The Raider can be a powerhouse if you use him aggressively enough. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a thumbs up. It really helps support the channel. If you really want to show your support, go ahead and hit that subscribe. I would really appreciate that too, and I will see you all in the next video.